Hi, I'm going to show you how to use the wireless sensor network example for the Simplink Wireless MCU, the CC1310. This example is bundled in TI Artos and it comes integrated in Code Composer Studio. So if you open Code Composer Studio and go to View Resource Explorer, you will get an overview of all the examples in TI Artos. So if we navigate down to RF examples, you'll see that there are several RF examples bundled with TI Artos. Two of these are the wireless sensor node concentrator and the wireless sensor network node. So if we go and open and click on them, we'll see on the right hand side here, we'll see four steps. The first step will import it into CCS. The second will build it. The third we will actually skip because it automatically detects the debugger you want to use. And four, you click to debug the project. So as you might have seen already, I've already performed step one and two. So on the left hand side, you can see that the concentrator and the node is already imported into Code Composer Studio. So we're going to start by programming up the concentrator here by clicking on it. And if you haven't already, make sure you import it and build it. And when you are done, just switch on the kit and then press debug the imported project. So what you're going to see is that the red LED will turn on the development board. This indicates that the debugger has connected to the target. So now it has already flashed the program to the board. And if we press play here, we will see on the screen that it's now waiting for nodes to connect. So let's stop the debugging right now and go back to the Resource Explorer, and it's time to explore the node. So let's do the same thing here. So you open the node in the Resource Explorer and you perform step one and two, import the project and build it. Again, I've already done it here. And then you simply do step four to debug the target. So what we're going to do is that we're going to turn off the concentrator to make sure it selects the right kit and then turn on the node. And then click debug again. So now we will flash this card with the node firmware. And this is the firmware that's going to report sensor data back to the concentrator. So now we've flashed the program to the node. So if we click resume here, we will actually see that LED 3 is turned on or toggles. So how this works is that it will toggle for every time that the light sensor changes its value enough. So if we cover and uncover the light sensor, we will see how the LED toggles and it will send data on the air. If we turn off the node and we turn on the concentrator again, we can again see that it's waiting for nodes. And the next thing we're going to do is that we'll turn on the node and the node will pop up in the LCD of the concentrator. And we can see here, if we cover or uncover the node sensor here, that the value updates in the display. So what we're going to do next is that we're going to add two more nodes and we're going to turn them on and see how they too appear in the LCD of the concentrator. So we can see that these values can also all be changed by uncovering or covering the nodes. So this is the wireless sensor node example. I believe that this can be a solid base for your software development.